Hi, Zach here, and here's a retopology video which I wish I had when I learned retopology in Blender using only free tools which are shipped with Blender by default. First, open up the object you want to retopologize, and let's disable a few viewport overlays and the gizmo here to have a cleaner 3D view. I'm using Blender 3.2 Alpha here, but this workflow should also work in basically any upcoming Blender version or older Blender versions. Then press F4, go to Preferences, Add-ons, search for BS, enable the Bsurfaces Add-on, search for F2, enable the F2 Add-on, and search for LOO and enable the LoopTools Add-on. Select your sculpting, press N, go to Edit, and here we find the Bsurfaces Add-on. Then press the Initialize button to create a basic retopology setup. This will now create an empty mesh object with the Shrinkwrap modifier on it. We will automatically switch to the Annotate tool, and the placement is set to surface, and the face snapping is also enabled automatically. The snapping and the Shrinkwrap modifier helps us to keep the new geometry on the surface of this sculpting. Then let's zoom in here a bit and start drawing your strokes. Like this, and then click on Add Surface. This will now generate the first geometry. Then let's open up the operator panel down here, and here you can change the subdivisions for the horizontal axis and also for the vertical axis. And you can also make it cyclic by checking cyclic cross. Then to make the workflow a bit easier for us, enable in front. This will always show this geometry in front of other objects. And here we can also change the color if you like, and you could even change the opacity by changing the alpha down here, but I like the default value. Since I'm working on a symmetrical mesh here, I want to have everything I do on one side mirror to the other side. For that, let's click on Add Mirror and Other Modifiers, which will add the mirror modifier, but also a subsurf and a solidify modifier, which we can remove here. We only keep the mirror modifier. Also, if we switch back to edit mode and I extrude something to the center here, you can see that this sticks to the mirroring axis here, and that's because clipping is enabled. However, it can be a bit annoying to always see the mirrored part on the other side, especially when you have a lot of geometry here. This can get quite messy. One thing we can do is to enable backface culling, which will make the backside of a face transparent, as you can see here. However, we can also disable the mirror modifier display in edit mode by checking this button here. And the cool thing is the mirroring still happens, the clipping still happens, but we can focus on one side of the mesh without getting distracted from the other side. Then to make the shrink wrap modifier work a bit better, change the wrap method to project and enable negative. Now back to the Bsurfaces add-on. There are now two ways to add new geometry. First of all, we can add loose geometry. Make sure everything is deselected by pressing Alt A, and then hold down D to temporarily enable the Annotate tool, and then you can start adding more strokes here. Then again, click Add Surface, which will generate this new surface. Make sure cyclic cross is disabled here. And for now, I want to keep the geometry relatively low resolution. We can add more loop cuts and so on later. Another way to add geometry here is to select one edge here. Make sure edge selection is enabled. And then you can draw additional strokes here and add the new geometry. And this will then automatically be connected to the selected edge. When using the Bsurfaces add-on, there's just one important thing you have to keep in mind. When drawing the strokes, let's hold on D and draw the strokes, you have to always draw them into the same direction. If I now draw this stroke here into the other direction, and then here again, let's go with the other direction, and I now generate this geometry, you can see that this edge here is now flipped, which I have drawn into the other direction. You can relatively quickly fix this by selecting this edge, press S to scale it, and basically scale it into the opposite direction. And by the way, if you accidentally made something wrong with these strokes, you can simply delete them by holding down D, right mouse button click, and then erases over here. Or if you click and hold on the Annotate tool, you also find the Annotate eraser, and then you can erase these strokes. And then if you continue here, it works as expected. Besides the Bsurfaces add-on, we can also use the default tools in Blender. For example, we can extrude with E, or we can extrude with holding down Control and then right clicking, then it will extrude to the position of your mouse. Then with Control R, we can add new loops to existing geometry, and you can see, depending on where I place my mouse, we get this preview. Then you can either scroll the mouse wheel or press page up and down to add more loops, then left click to confirm, then you can slide them around, then with left click you can confirm the new position or simply right click to snap them back to the center. You can remove loops by having edge selection enabled and pressing Ctrl X to dissolve them. And you can also slide existing geometry by selecting it, pressing double G to slide it around, and this also works with vertices when having the vertex selection enabled. Then, as you maybe remember, we also enabled the F2 add-on, which is also a great addition to use in the retopology process. Let's extrude a few faces here. And now let's imagine we want to add another row of faces up here. For that, simply select one vertex in a corner, make sure vertex selection is enabled, and then press F to just add a new face. And we can do it again and again. After this, you can automatically tweak this new added vertex over here and with left click place it and then add a new face. This is a fantastic workflow to quickly fill in more geometry, as you can see. Then we also enable the loop tools. When you press N, go to edit, you can find the loop tools over here. And this offers a few more options to adjust your geometry. A few of them which are pretty cool, for example, when you selected a circular shape here, you can make a perfect circle out of this. Or you can relax the geometry to kind of smooth it a bit. Or if you want to make all edges along one edge loop the same length, you can click on the space button. Now each of this edge has the exact same length. Now keep in mind that face snapping was enabled over here as we initialized the Bsurface mesh. You can always turn it off if you like, but let's keep it on here. And now when I select geometry and move it around, this will automatically be projected onto the surface from our view. This is very useful. However, this can also cause some issues. For example, if I view the mesh from here, press G to move the vertices around, it looks as everything is nice. However, now you can see it was projected on this surface here. So always make sure to view the geometry which you are moving around from the right perspective. Besides snapping over here, we have also the Shrinkwrap modifier, which also helps us to project the geometry of the Retopo mesh onto our sculpting over here. And this works by selecting the target down here, which was automatically done by the Bsurfaces add-on. However, the Shrinkwrap modifier works a bit differently than the snapping. Let's disable snapping up here, and also let's disable the Shrinkwrap modifier for a second. And then let's move one vertex a bit further away from the geometry, so it's floating in space up here. However, when I now re-enable the Shrinkwrap modifier, this vertex gets projected onto the near-lying surface. If I disable this button, we can still see the original position of this vertex, and you can see how this is projected when I move this around. The problem here, when this button is enabled and I now move the vertex around, I don't know where it originally was positioned, and thus this behaves a bit weirdly. And this is why we enable snapping, to always project it directly onto the surface when we move a vertex around. However, there's a problem. When we use certain tools, for example like adding a loop cut here, this is where the Shrinkwrap modifier shines, because here all these vertices will not be projected automatically using the snapping. If we want to do this, we had to press G to move them again. But if we don't do this, you can see how the Shrinkwrap modifier projects this new loop onto the surface. So, and this is why the Shrinkwrap modifier is useful. However, every now and then during the retopology process, I duplicate and apply the Shrinkwrap modifier. So we go to object mode, duplicate it, and for the top Shrinkwrap modifier, I simply apply it. Then all the vertices which are maybe floating in space still will be reprojected onto the surface. So we are actually affecting the original mesh here. Now, if I enable and disable it, everything is in place. So if you ever notice that some vertices are behaving a bit weirdly, just duplicate and apply the Shrinkwrap modifier. Also, one important note here, up here, auto merge vertices is enabled by default. That means if you move two vertices close to each other, they will be merged. This is of course super cool sometimes. If you have something like this and then, for example, extrude over here, then these vertices here will be merged automatically. However, this can also cause problems when you move geometry a bit close together. It will also merge it, maybe even if we don't want. You can reduce the threshold over here, so you have to really move them super close to merge them together. Or if this is annoying, you can just disable it completely up here. Now we know how to use the tools, but how do we actually place a new geometry on the surface? The general idea here is to follow the flow of the shape and make sure that areas that deform later on, like the eyelids for example, have a certain topology to be able to perform the deformation, like opening and closing the eyelids. So usually I start with defining important loops first without connecting them. Like here a circle around the eyes, a loop around the mouse, and then also some loops along hard edges or important landmarks. Here I keep the resolution relatively low to keep it simple. We can add more loop cuts later on. Then when all the major loops are in place, I connect them by filling in open areas. In general, I try to use quads only, meaning faces with four sides. This allows us to get nicer results later on if we subdivide the mesh, but it especially helps us in the editing process since only quads allow us to quickly add loop cuts, for example, or later on in the UV unwrapping process to easily add seams in different areas. In short, quads will make your life a lot easier. So try to avoid trees or engines, meaning faces with less or more than four vertices. In terms of how detailed you should make the retopology, it is of course up to you, but you should at least add as much geometry that all important shapes are included. Of course, you don't need to focus on retopologizing small scales or surface details here, but we need the eye shapes, the mouse shapes, maybe some topology for the nostrils, and so on and so forth. And as always, if the resolution is too low later on, we can always subdivide the mesh. Another little thing that can happen when you retopologize your mesh, for example, let's add more geometry over here using the Bsurfaces add-on. Add surface, and now you can see this also is transparent. So we are seeing the backside of these faces down here. So we have to flip them. For that, hover above one vertex of this area, press L to link select, so everything which is connected will be selected. And then you can press Ctrl Shift N to flip this geometry. Then let's add one loop over here, similar as at the top, and then we can simply fill this area with F. Now, when your retopology is done, of course, here I just retopologized the top part of the head. Let's go back to object mode. Let's select the select tool here. Duplicate the shrinkwrap modifier and apply the first one so everything is reprojected onto the surface. However, the mesh looks still a bit messy, as you can see. We have some closer lying faces, bigger areas, and so on and so forth. And in order to fix this, let's actually switch to sculpt mode. And here, let's extend this a bit. We have this slide relax tool. And the cool thing about this is that this allows us to move the vertices around without affecting the volume of the object. So we are just moving the topology. So and by default, we can just move things around. Let's reduce the strength a bit, as you can see. We can change this to pinch, which like squeezes the geometry together. And we can also change this to expand, which will push the geometry away from each other. But the best tool here is to simply hold down Shift, which will enable the smooth option. And then, oh, look at that, how satisfying it is to go over the geometry and smooth everything a bit. Super nice. And as always, if there is too little geometry, you can add more if you like. So, and now imagine you have everything retopologized. Now to wrap it up, you apply the shrinkwrap modifier and you apply the mirror modifier. And as final step, make sure that here at the center, all vertices from the mirroring axis are actually merged because sometimes you have little holes there. So, and if you want to add an extra level of smoothing, you can add the smooth modifier here and repeat it a few times and then apply it. This of course works a bit better if you have everything retopologized and don't have an open mesh over here. Then you can remove the material, and in the object tab under viewport display, you can disable wire and in front. Now let's hide the original creature, and here's our pure retopology mesh. Learning these skills is relatively easy, mastering them takes time. If you want to dive deeper into retopology and especially sculpting in Blender, check out my comprehensive sculpting course on academy.cgboost.com. This is a great way to improve your skills and to support what we do. Thanks for watching, Zach out.